be the one doing your Lederhosen fitting today. Yes, that's right. Everything we do is personally tailored just to you. So, this is going to take a little bit of time because I'm going to have to do some measurements of your body so that we can sew everything perfectly to your proportions. And yeah, I see that you're wearing really comfortable clothing, so that's going to make it a lot easier for me to get the correct measurements. So thank you for doing that. Okay. Well, it's still quite hot out, isn't it? Would you like some refreshment? I have a new fest beer that I can serve you. Sure. Let's see. This one is the Hofbrauhaus Oktoberfest beer. Okay, would you like it? Let me just pour it into a mug for you. Smells so good. I haven't tried this one yet, but I'm sure it's gonna be delicious. Okay, let me put it on the table next to you. Okay, so before I do your measurements, I would like to talk a little bit about Lederhosen. So, I have one of our sample pairs. This one is made out of cow leather, but for a premium price, I can make it out of deer leather. And the difference is a higher cost, quite significant, but it's also much more soft and comfortable. However, with cow skin and goat skin Lederhosen, I also sew a lining on the inside, which is very soft and still makes the Lederhosen very comfortable too. Okay. So, this is the shorts part of the Lederhosen, and Lederhosen itself means leather pants or shorts, so name is very fitting. I can do two different lengths. At least there are two different lengths of Lederhosen. This one I'm showing is the longer version, and it goes down just below your knee. But there's also another version which comes to above the knee. To you. As you can see, it's made out of a very durable leather, and it had to be because Lederhosen were traditionally used as work shorts or pants. So, leather can handle a lot of rough activity and also potentially dangerous work, so that's why it's made out of leather. And yes, this is a double flap fly, and it's called the little door, or my favorite, the serving plate. just opens with a couple of nice heavy duty buttons for a fly. And your Lederhosen are, of course, held up by suspenders. That's another very integral part. Two parts here. Your suspenders that go over your shoulder like this, and then there's a, I guess, bib that goes right. We use a very fine metal buckles on our suspenders. Oh, yes. So you noticed the intricate embroidery on Lederhosen. It's a wonderful part and provides opportunities for customization for your Lederhosen. So, traditionally, the embroider would be symbolic of whatever town you're from. However, I can do whatever sort of embroidery you want. I've done some very cool stuff based on clients' wishes. I think one of my favorite recent ones was to mugs of beer flowing down and turning into a beautiful floral design as it went down. I thought it was a very cool customization, especially for a Lederhosen that was going to be primarily used at Oktoberfest and other beer festivals across Germany. So, something for you to think about, especially while I measure you. We can do traditional German floral patterns, traditional Bavarian patterns, or other European patterns, or whatever you like, we can do, okay? So, underneath your suspenders, you're also going to want to wear a shirt, course. So, I recommend a checkered shirt, such as this one. You can really go for any color that you would like, any combination of colors. Blue, red, and white colors. Or another option is a more traditional white shirt. You don't need to go really fancy with this. There are traditional German shirts you could purchase as well. This is just a white collared shirt. Okay. Something crisp. And I personally recommend something made of a natural fiber, such as cotton, just because it's going to be a lot more comfortable throughout your day when you're wearing it. And when you're outside in the sun, beautiful September weather, you'll probably want a cotton shirt. So a couple other accessories. You will want to get a pair of knee purchase these ones. And again, I recommend a natural fiber. You can go for cotton or wool. Personally, I would recommend the cotton just because it'll be a lot easier to clean. And if you decide the shorter version of Lederhosen is to your liking, then you will wear these socks up to your knee. And if you decide on the longer version, you will roll them down a bit towards your shoe. Okay. But here's a wonderful example. Typically, you'll go for an off-white coloring, such as these grayish cream socks. And finally, you will need an alpine hat, such as this one. So you can see we have a German flag colors cording around this one. And you also want one with a flag. Now, I also can provide this for you. Yeah, great. So there's a couple of different customization options that I offer. I can provide whatever cording colors you would like. If you have a particular color combination that you like or means something to you, we can do that. And I have some other really striking feather options. Peacock feathers, pheasant feathers. I have a very fancy white plumage rosette. We could do something a little more flashy. Whatever you decide. To do some measurements for that. Okay. So what do you think? If there's any other ideas you have for me, I can hear that at any time, okay? Great. Okay. Now I can get some of your measurements. My notebook here, and I'll write them down into that. Okay. So I do have to get quite a few measurements. Okay, so you can just sit there and relax. Okay, so let me start by getting your chest measurement. Waist. come around to your back here and get a couple measurements. Your neck to hip. To get your inseam measurement. So just spread your leg out there. Okay, and then inseam to knee. Then I'd like to check both legs just in case there's a big difference. Too big of a difference between the legs, so that's good. Sometimes there is, and I have to make adjustments. That way your hat is going to fit perfectly. You can pick the right size for you. Okay. Let me see. I think that's all I need. Okay. to show you some leather samples. Like I mentioned earlier, we have cow leather, goat leather, as well as deerskin leather. Okay. Now, the deerskin is definitely more expensive, but it's the most high quality that we have. We also have some non-traditional colors if you're wanting to go into a more unique route. This one is deerskin leather, and you can feel, if you would, how incredibly soft it is. Isn't it quite soft? This is a cowskin leather, and while it still is soft, it's just a little bit more stiff. Traditional colors. This is also deerskin. It's very soft. It's a very smooth hand to it. And then here's also kind of a darker colored option. It's a very rich, dark brown color. Okay. Then I also have this grayish blue. Also black. This one is quite nice, isn't it? Yes. Okay. Now this one is goat leather. It is definitely more stiff. You can feel the deer. So just keep that in mind. It's not uncomfortable to wear though, I find. Yes, this is another cow leather. Very structured, so it will make a very structured short, so it's not always a bad thing. And finally, this is another deer leather option. Very soft, very movable. Think you'll go with the more traditional colors. That's a good idea. Especially if it's your first pair of Lederhosen. I think it's better to have a standard pair first. Right, rather than going with the crazy pair for your first one. Okay. So, last but not least, let me show you the options for embroidery colors. So traditionally, greens and yellows are the traditional colors we would do for the embroidery. However, I'd like to provide all options. So we have pink, orange, a couple of different options for the yellow. Goldenrod and this sunshine yellow. And for greens, we have this saturated hunter green. It's also kind of a sage green. And then we also have a white, which is on the example that I showed you earlier. Couple of different blues as well. Okay. You can also do a combination of colors if that's what you like to. Okay. All right. So now that you've had a chance to think, I will just write down. Write down what you're thinking for your embroidery, for we already know that you want to do a traditional leather. And you said that you have a proper checkered shirt already. Include with your lederhosen the socks. The ones that I showed you are fine, so we could do those. And for the hats, what colors were you thinking for the cording? How about for the feather? Okay. Like a heather feather for the feather, right? Good. And then for the embroidery, do you have a specific design? Sure, that's fine. We could definitely do that. I really like that idea. Yeah. How about for the colors? Sure. Perfect. That sounds really good. Also, what length do you want it to? Okay. Okay, let's see. I think that's everything. So, let me just have you look down here. Perfect, okay, let's just sign off on that. Okay, so that's it. And I'm going to get started on this right away. And it will be ready for your Oktoberfest celebration. Okay, it was so nice working with you.